Senior Day festivities wrapping up here at the Palestra, and now on to the task at hand. March Madness has reached the Ivy League. For the first time, there will be a conference tournament, and these two teams could factor in a big way. Good evening, everyone, along with Vince Curran, Joe Torti here with you. Vince, Harvard has already punched their ticket, emotional loss last night against Princeton. Penn has some work to do tonight if they want to clinch their spot.
You need a degree in advanced calculus to figure out all the iterations of the playoff potentials in the Ivy League. Here's what Penn knows. Penn knows they have to win tonight to have a chance at that. It gets easy if Columbia loses and Penn wins, and then we'll be talking about it the whole second half if we start tracking these games down and seeing how they're playing out.
We'll keep you posted with all the relevant tiebreakers. You take a look at this Harvard starting lineup. The senior point guard, Siani Chambers. Other than that, four freshmen in the starting lineup for the Crimson.
Here's the greatest compliment that people can pay to opposing players. I'm ready for Siani Chambers to go. He is a terrific player. He has been around forever. He is a great leader for Tommy Amaker. He has been a terrific representative of the Ivy League. Go get a job, son. It's time. Move on. He has just been a terrific player for them and really been a key to all the success they've had at Harvard over the last couple of years.
For more on tonight's matchup, we head down to Varun Raghupathy. Varun.
Hey, Joe. Hey, Vince. Good to hear from you, and good evening. It's the final Ivy League game of the regular season for both Penn and Harvard. Two teams coming off of close losses, Penn falling to Dartmouth by two, and Harvard losing narrowly to Princeton. Had a chance to catch up with Harvard's assistant coach, Mike Sotsky, and he told me a couple things. First, as it relates to Penn, he said that the Quakers are a much faster team when it comes to their pace as opposed to the first time Penn and Harvard played a game the Crimson won. On the other side, Harvard likes its ability to play improvisational basketball. Now, what does that mean? Well, they can scramble well, maybe not get into their sets too well, but still come out on top. And that's something that Sotsky says that Harvard has been developing throughout the year. They may not have been great at it at first, but moving forward along this season, they've gotten better at thinking on their feet and making sure they can make productive plays, even if things don't exactly go according to plan. Penn trying to take down Harvard, split the season series here at the Palestra, coming up.
Varun, thank you very much. Penn awaiting their introductions, and it was a little bit of a slow start for the Quakers last night, Vince, against Dartmouth, and in this, a must-win spot, you'd expect a much quicker beginning to the game.
Two slow starts, actually, for Penn. There were two sections of the game where the offense just disappeared, and they found themselves in deficits and fought their way back. Can't happen tonight. I look for Matt Howard to try and establish himself early, attack that athletic Harvard team off the bounce, and look for A.J. Broder on the interior, trying to give Steve Donahue a little stability on the offensive end.
Ryan Bentley, a freshman for Penn, averaging 19 points over the last six games, including 19 last night. He's been really good.
Yeah, he's been really good. There's no doubt about that. I'm surprised he didn't get that last look last night. I thought Jackson Donahue comes into the game. He's a little undersized. I think if you put Bentley out there to make that entry pass, maybe he's able to see over the top. Maybe he's able to play off Broder. Didn't work out for Steve Donahue. 20-20 hindsight on my part. But Bentley has been very good throughout the second half of this Ivy League season.
Penn Quakers need to win. The easiest path for them into the Ivy League tournament is for Columbia to lose. Take a look at that starting lineup. Four freshmen for Harvard in the ESPN Top 100. This is a Crimson team that's going to stick around for a while. On the flip side, you take a look at the Penn Quakers. They're another one of those young, talented teams. Bentley and Broder, the two freshmen, but Donahue, just a sophomore, and Foreman will be back next year as well.
And don't forget about Dev Goodman as well. So three talented freshmen. Darnell Foreman, talk about stability, has really provided that for Steve Donahue. And Penn has really turned it around once Ryan Bentley sees his minutes increase. He's been a very good offensive perimeter threat for the Quakers.
Tommy Amaker's Harvard Crimson control as Towns, one of those freshmen at the top of the key, had a career night last night against Princeton. Inside, Chris Lewis against Broder. Chambers whips it to Aiken, held to 2 points last night against Princeton. And Towns unable to pick up where he left off. Howard, the senior, rips down the board in his 100th game as a Quaker. Roeder finds Foreman. Nice find inside. Howard nearly left open for three. Senior to the rack, and he spins it off the window for two.
Good ball movement early against that Harvard man-to-man inside-out action. Really a nice catch by Broder. And then a nice attack off the bounce by Matt Howard.
Aiken with Foreman guarding him. Uses a Lewis screen. Leading scorer for the Crimson, over 14 points per game. Chambers with six to shoot, pulls up. Splash. Chambers looking for the foul as well. Tie game at two.
Siani Chambers been around a little too long to get tricked by the fake countdown by the Penn band. Pretty good crowd here on senior night, Joe. Up two-thirds full. That's with the students being off on spring break. Let it go, son.
Howard feeling it on senior night, the first 5 points of the game. Aiken trying to answer for Harvard. Chambers trying to get around Donahue. Towns dumps it down to Lewis. Broder guarding him. Strong hook shot and a good rebound by Broder. Here comes Penn.
A nice challenge by Broder. Does a good job pushing Lewis off the block. And Matt Howard, he got the memo. Last night at the Palestra, you got a win and you might get a chance to play a couple more here.
Howard headed to the free throw line. There he shoots 58%. Howard on the nice backdoor cut. Good body control to get a quality shot.
I said in his senior, what we call that, vignette, his fondest memory or his first memory at the Plaster was clanking badly two free throws in his first game against Temple.
No memories here on senior night clanking the first
game. Forget about it. Forget about it, Joe.
Vince, any letdown here for Harvard after that emotional loss to Princeton? Lewis loses it on the way up. And it'll stay here with Penn.
Well, at this point, if you're Harvard, the tough thing is, like, if you said it's Siani Chambers and Wes Saunders and a veteran group, you say no chance, right? Now you got Siani Chambers who's leading this group, and then you have four freshmen not used to being in this situation, coming off a tough loss last night, without a whole lot to play for in terms of seeding. So you could see a little bit of a letdown, but not from Aiken right there. That's poise, that's veteran poise as that shot clock's winding down. Good attack and pull up creates a little space.
Aiken not gonna wait till the second half of this game to score. Foreman can't get the three to fall. Here's Towns. Now Chambers, the floor general controlling for Harvard. Towns left open. And Howard with the rebound. He's been assertive early on. Howard. And probing the perimeter. Senior Howard steps in, loses it on the way up. He was fouled. 3-point lead for Penn, and for the second time early on, it'll be Howard heading to the free throw line. That's also two quick fouls on the inside there for Towns, and that's big. Howard 3-for-3 from the line. Here Harvard goes to the bench. Zena Edosumwon, a key contributor a season ago, a starter for Tommy Amaker's squad, now comes off the bench.
Tough for a veteran to accept that role when freshmen come in like that. But by all accounts, Edosumwon has been the ultimate team player. And it's certainly a luxury for Tommy Amaker to have that kind of depth along with the talented young freshman.
Inside, stripped is Edosumwon, and now coming back the other way, it's Penn. Good defense by the Quakers. Foreman floats one over everybody's head. Donahue tracks it down. 10 by 5, 3.5 minutes in at the Palestra. It's senior night. Matt Howard, lone senior contributor. Dylan Jones also on the roster. A.J. Broder rims in and out. Bassey drops it down low and a two-handed stuff by Edosimo. Good vision by Bassey there.
Harvard does a really nice job on the miss by Broder of getting the rebound and getting into their offense quickly. See, I don't like that foul. I don't like that foul call right there. I don't think there's a whole lot of advantage. Johnson, not a ton of contact. Should be a play on, in my opinion. But my vote doesn't count, Joe. And what does count? Penn with an early 9-6 lead, 15:53 to go. Getting it done from the perimeter. Matt Howard off to the fast start.
Here's a good look at Steve Chopnick, a 50-year Penn basketball season ticket holder being honored at midcourt. Good dedication to the Quaker cause there. And he's honored tonight on senior night and alumni night.
One of the things that makes Penn special, the family and the people that are here year after year, and in Steve's case, decade after decade.
Rothschild traveled on his first touch. Got a brief look at our players of the game. Siani Chambers, the point guard, one of those for Harvard. And it's a senior among freshmen, especially in that starting lineup. Bassey being guarded by Matt Howard, a senior. Aiken working around Foreman. Aiken hit as he throws it up. No head to the free throw line. Bryce Aiken. Picks up the foul on Foreman.
Foreman gets a little hung up on the screen by Ndosimwan. You see the savvy of Aiken kind of senses that. Leans his way into Foreman, creates the contact, almost gets himself an and one.
Aiken an 88% free throw shooter, missing the first. Checking in there is Robert Baker, another freshman, 6'10", from Woodstock, Georgia. Aiken 1-for-2 from the stripe.
Matt McDonald in for Penn, his first action in a few games, as Dev Goodman also in running the point for Steve Donahue.
This is going to be a matchup in the Ivy League, Aiken versus Goodman. You'll be watching for years to come. Two very talented freshman point guards. Goodman finds Rothschild, 9 seconds to shoot, he's trapped. Goodman lets it fly from the corner, and Bentley, the offensive glass. Penn with a new set.
Talk about, a lot about that with Bentley, his size on the tip of the 1-3-1 defense, but also as a rebounder, his athleticism right there in effort.
Gets How about Penn that a second athleticism? Look. Howard can't finish. Now it's Aiken coming back the other way. Corey Johnson, a three-point gunner. Just missed a good look at the end of last night's game. And Osamwan fired up as he puts it in. Tie game at 9. McDonald works his way in. Missed the layup.
Max Rothschild needs to be ready to catch and shoot that. Twice he's gotten a little intimidated by Ndosimwan.
Aiken lets it fly, and that's the second time in 2 games that he's badly missed a three-pointer from the top of the key.
And we've seen a couple of them. The kid from Dartmouth hits the corner of the backboard last night and sees one goes in. And there was another one that was missed by about 5 feet up the backboard. I've never seen one miss like that. And Aiken, pretty good shooter. Slipped, coach. Slipped.
Well, he's fearless as well. He won't shy away from the next one. Broder versus Edosimo. Howard working his way into the lane and hits the floater. Matt Howard has leapt to, well, all of Penn's points. He's got all 11.
Feed the bear. Go to the hot hand. Matt Howard off the dribble.
Aiken. Baker passes it out. Aiken with 10 to shoot. Good defense by Penn man-to-man. Palestra crowd appreciates that. Three to shoot for Bassey. He gets hit. And that should be a shot clock violation. They'll say Penn had possession and comes back the other way.
Nice job by the officials with the no call. Bassey, the little flop. And Matt McDonald off the bounce. If at first you don't succeed, try again. A little wild on the first one. That time getting into the middle of the lane. Able to get the soft roll. All Matt's all the time here. 11 for Matt Howard and 2 for Matt McDonald.
Now a foul call on the moving screen of Osamone, warding him off. And that's his first, already the 14th foul on Harvard. Seth Towns back in. Keep an eye on 31 for Harvard as he's playing with 2 fouls. There's a good look at the foul on at Osamone.
The official says to him, he's coming up the floor, you give the handoff and you keep moving into the defender. They'll call it that way every time.
Penn working the ball around, leading Harvard by 4 in the early going. Broder. Now Howard working his way in. And Towns with the board. Chambers on the run for Harvard. Good crossover, leaves Bentley in the dust. Towns. And Bentley gets in the way. You talk about it all the time, Vince.
Such a nice job by Broder, though, picking up Bentley after he flies out to challenge the shooter.
Broder caught underneath. Bentley, another offensive rebound. But it's blocked by Baker, and here comes Harvard again. Chambers, pass goes errant. And it'll stay here with the Crimson.
Timeout.
10 by 4 with 11:59 to go here on senior night at the Palestra. Matt Howard fired up. He had Penn's first 11 points. Harvard hanging around. Here's 2 of them for Matt Howard. Back inside the Palestra. Penn band feeling good as the Quakers lead by 4 over Harvard. Take a look here. Penn, after such a slow start, Steve Donahue asked about it. You got a game at the Palestra versus a really good team, and you got a good chance to go to the postseason if you win. If you told me then, when we were 0-6, that we could play a home game with a good chance of advancing, I would have married you. I don't know if he's talking to you in particular. That's what
he wasn't talking to me, but you know, his wife Pam's behind us, and she might be ready. You know what?
She might have something to say
go
about
ahead.
That.
No, she said, you know, go ahead. We've had a good run. I've had enough of you.
Now here.
I'm going to ask you. She's 2 rows behind us.
You'll have to turn around and see. Chambers finds Towns playing with 2 fouls. Pulls up from the free throw line. And after having such a nice night against Princeton, a little bit of a slow start offensively. Goodman, good vision. Bentley left open. Jones held off by that rebound, and now Goodman lets it fly. And Lewis tracks it down for Harvard. Here comes Chambers. Bassey. Towns took a look at Sam Jones. Chambers pulls up with a long 2 and splashes it down. The lefty, Siani Chambers. Harvard back to within 2 here at the Palestra. Penn needs to win this game to make the Ivy League tournament. Bentley hits the 3, doing his part to help the cause.
And that's one of the things we talked about earlier in the year, Ryan Bentley being ready to catch and shoot coming off that down screen. In rhythm, big 3 from the perimeter. That is a travel in every league except this one, apparently.
Towns working on Bentley. Misses again on the floater, and Penn with the rebound. This time, McDonald doing battle for it.
Towns does a nice job of getting to about 8 feet. Bentley challenges, plays him relatively physically without fouling.
About halfway through the first half, Penn by 5. Jones, quick trigger. Bingo! Sam Jones hits from the corner.
Steve Donahue said to me before the game, he said, I'd love to see Sam Jones get a shot off. Played 10 minutes last night, didn't really even look at the basket. The point of emphasis at the shoot-around today. Sam, if you get it and you're open, you got to let it go.
Jones scored 27 points last season in a game, has taken a more complimentary role, whereas he was one of the team's primary scorers in the early part of last season. Pass bounces around to Lewis. Look what I found. Chris Lewis, right place, right time, penned by six.
Another tip ball, though. Now Harvard, it looks like they're in a zone for the first time.
McDonald lets it fly. Towns calling for Chambers to come get it. Baker back to Towns with a head of steam to the rack. Batted around. And it'll stay here with Harvard. Last touch by Jones. Darnell Foreman checking into the game along with Max Rothschild for Penn.
This one's going to test your endurance. Not a whole lot of stops in this game. End to end quickly. Not a whole lot of foul called. And there's one Penn fans can't be happy about. Columbia jumping on Yale early in the first half. Princeton putting it on Dartmouth at Jadwin Gym. So that fourth playoff spot getting a little clearer.
Aiken can't hit the pull-up. Has to like the shot selection, though. Penn obviously looking for Columbia to lose to Yale. Muscled up by Bentley, late foul call, and Bentley will head to the free throw line. He's one of Penn's best free throw shooters when he heads to the stripe. He is over a 92% shooter.
92 be best on a lot of teams, and on a team like Penn that has really struggled from the line this year, astronomical. That's a tough call for Baker. What do they got? They get Baker there?
They credited it to Edosimwan. That's his second.
That's an even tougher call for Edosimwan.
Bentley, been a nice story, has been a key scorer for Penn after missing most of the early part of the season with that wrist injury. As Penn leads by eight. Quakers trying to do their part to punch the ticket to the tournament. Harvard locked into the two seed. Here's Baker, and he hits for three. Harvard fell in love with the three-point shot against Princeton last night, hit half of them.
This is a serious 1-3-1 zone for Harvard. The length of Baker and the size and strength of Ndosimwan patrolling that foul line. That's the look right there. Elbows and gaps.
Good wrap pass by Howard. And Rothschild tied up. Jump ball, it'll stay here with Penn.
Four seconds
left on the shot clock. And that 1-3-1 zone defense, you saw it slow down the start to Penn's offense, and they got going a little late in the shot clock. Rothschild frustrated with that jump ball call.
Easy one.
There's a five. Oh no, they call a foul.
Moving screen, Max Rothschild. This has been a tough start for Rothschild. I think the length and athleticism of Harvard is in his head right now. He's had a couple looks inside that he's hesitated on. He just needs to trust his, yeah, no doubt about it. He needs to trust his ability to get the ball up on the glass.
Chambers all the way in, lays it in and one. Siani Chambers strikes. And he earns a trip to the free throw line. 7:58 to go here at the Palestra. Chambers, the senior, doing what he can to pull Harvard closer. Quick move to get around Goodman. Good body control as he gets bumped.
Welcome back to the Palestra. What an atmosphere. Penn ahead of Harvard, 21-18 Ivy League regular season finale. Now you look at this Crimson team. Bursting the six out is their size, big and strong. Talked to assistant coach Mike Sotsky, says they're going to use that to their advantage against a Penn team that loves doing four guard lineups. If Harvard can get two bigs on the floor at all times, the Crimson believes they'll be in good shape in the post and on the board, showing Vince.
Thank you very much, Tommy Amaker's squad. Like you said, and like Varun just alluded to, very big, very long, very athletic. Siani Chambers, the senior, hits at the free throw line, and he's orchestrating the whole attack.
We've been doing that for a long time up in Cambridge.
Bentley with a step on Baker. Broder thought about the three. Good find for Howard. Five to shoot for Penn. Goodman finds Broder. Has to throw it up. And he missed everything. Shot clock violation. And this zone morphing defense for Harvard starting to give Penn some trouble.
They see Foreman gets the ball on the cut. He's not comfortable going up with it. Dev Goodman gets in the lane. Didn't look like he was ready to go up with it. And Broder rushing at the end of the shot clock. And Dosiman, a tough matchup for Broder just because of his strength.
He's got it now, holding it above his head. Chambers nearly got caught in the air. Aiken inside, and good patience and ball movement results in a Baker easy one.
That Baker's length going to be a factor in this game. Tommy Amaker has put him on Bentley after seeing Bentley knock down a few long ones early. Question will now be, can Baker stay with Bentley as he runs through a series of screens looking for his shot?
Tie game at 21. 10 to shoot for Penn. Foreman, pick and roll, and it goes off of Broder out of bounds. And it'll be Harvard ball. Bassey checking in as Baker takes a seat.
And here's that stretch where Penn can't get anything going offensively. We've seen it several times. So that one looked like it was out off of Dosimwan. A.J. Broder thinking the same thing.
Penn in a man-to-man defensive look. They led by as many as eight. An 8-0 run by Harvard has it all square. Cassie. Good vision, and then Dosimwan ends it. He smashes down a dunk, and now it's a Harvard lead for the first time. Jackson Donahue into the ball game for the first time since early on. Bentley, no. Howard finishes, no. Broder has it go through his back pocket, and this is Bassey of Harvard. A near steal for Broder. And the timeout called by Harvard. Players everywhere, everyone laying out as they were looking for the ball there on the ground. The officials emphatic in that timeout called by Tommy Amaker.
Not emphatic. Can't say they're right or wrong. I think wrong. I think you need to have better control of the ball to be able to call a timeout. And this one from Matt Howard. How does this not go in? It's around once. It's around one and a half. Oh. Tough break for Matt Howard. Looks like Broder's going to be there to clean up the loose change. He fights it a little bit. Harvard gets it going in the other direction.
Vince, you alluded to it moments ago, but when Penn is clicking, they can play with anybody in the Ivy League. But too often this season for the Quakers, there have been long stretches where they've struggled to score.
Well, offensive firepower, consistent offensive firepower. Brian Bentley has solved that problem a little bit, but you can't put it all on one guy to be your perimeter offense. Sam Jones knocks one down earlier in the game. You're going to need to see contributions from other places, because once that starts to happen, then A.J. Broder has room to operate. Matt Howard has room to go off the bounce.
Broder scoreless at the moment.
Lob.
And Osamwan finishes. Good vision, and Adosamwan just snuck behind the D. Harvard by four.
As much behind the D, it was the matchup of Dev Goodman on and Dosimwan. Chambers sees it. Terrific recognition by the senior point guard, and he knows what to do.
Howard breaks the cold streak with the floater, and Howard's got 13, trying to keep Penn in it. Harvard back to work. Chambers slams on the brakes. Penn fighting for the rebound, and good save by Matt Howard.
We talk so often about how no teams play for the 15-foot jump shot anymore. Gianni Chambers is the exception to that rule. He really likes to get to that 12, 14, 15-foot range and see what he can get done.
Schroeder offensive follow, lays it in.
That's created by Bentley going off the bounce. Bentley and Dosunmu has to come over and help out. And Broder gets a clean rebound and clean look back at it. That's his first basket, Matt. Joe, whatever your name is.
Aikens steps into a three, absorbs some contact as well.
How you doing? I'm Vince Curran.
Yeah, nice to meet you, Vince. I'm Matt or whatever you just called me. It's 28-25.
Matt Leon's doing the radio across the way.
Goodman. Last game of the season. We're still getting to know each other.
Last game of our second season together.
Our second season.
At least I'm not calling you Celtics.
And there's a foul as Howard driving in. And now a little bit of extra as Howard and Bassey get tangled up.
Timeout.
3:51 left in the first half. Howard can pull Penn back to within two. On a pair of free throws, Bassey rung up for that one. As Harvard has jumped out in front of Penn. Good vision by Chambers. And Osamwan is eaten early and often. Halftime quickly approaching here as Penn and Harvard lock up in the final Ivy League regular season game here at the Palestra. With Vince Curran, I'm Joe Torti. Glad to be bringing you the action on the Ivy League Digital Network. Coming up at halftime, we'll have an interview with Penn alum Fran Dougherty, and then we'll go around the Ivy League. Probably no more important weekend for going around the Ivy League than this one, Vince.
Fran Dougherty, the MVP of the alumni game this afternoon. He's here with his fiance. Talk about a guy that outkicked his coverage. You know a little something about that, Joe.
I know it well. Howard was called for a foul on the floor, and now a traveling violation is called. It'll be a turnover. That was not a problem for Penn last night. Six turnovers was a low in the Steve Donahue era. Chambers walking it up. Cornell comfortably in front of Brown as that game winds down. Aiken muscling his way in and a foul called on the floor.
Doing a little scoreboard watching, are you, Joe?
I might also be able to tell you that Columbia is up 7 points on the Yale Bulldogs.
The Quakers, number four, Darnell.
There's about 3 minutes until halftime in that one. They're just a hair ahead of this game. Aiken muscling his way in. Not very many players that can go tit for tat with Dev Goodman in terms of quickness. Aiken is one of those.
And Princeton smoked Dartmouth at Jadwin, so the Big Green eliminated from contention for that four spot.
Step back for Aiken. And Broder collects the carom. Here comes Foreman for Penn. 3 minutes left in the first half. Penn down three. Foreman nearly able to get that one to go. Free throws upcoming for the junior. Foreman, 69% free throw shooter.
Is it me or has this been a year of balls rolling out for Penn? I mean, Darnell Foreman almost has an and one this year. Broder's probably had 50 of them like that.
And of course, Howard had probably the most spectacular one earlier as Foreman just about able to get that to go. He hits the second one. And Matt McDonald. And McDonald started many early season games for Penn, has seen his playing time reduced in the recent going, especially in Ivy League play.
Yeah, I think Steve Donahue likes him on Siani Chambers. Little bigger, physical, mature defender.
And Aiken draws the foul, but on the floor as Foreman gets rung up for that one. That'll be his second. Now Seth Towns checking back in. Towns had a rim-rattling dunk last night in the game against Princeton. Came down on his hip, had to leave the game, looked serious. Came back in and threw another one down. Chambers, there's the defensive matchup you talked about, Vince, with McDonald. Bassey shows the ball. Towns with eight to shoot. Moving in on Howard and a foul call. Donahue looking for the traveling violation, but instead the foul will be called on Bentley.
I think Steve Donahue has a case. It started right there. Towns. So he does a little hockey step. Rock-a-bye baby, get started.
81% free throw shooter is Seth Towns. He hits. Towns part of a prized recruiting class for Tommy Amaker. Turned down several Big Ten schools to land here at Harvard. He puts the Crimson back up by three. Baker in for Towns. A little bit of offense, defense with Towns playing with those two fouls. Here's the offensive set for Penn. And now a foul called on Lewis on the entry pass. And Lewis, that'll be his first foul.
Not sure what Lewis is protesting right there. He pretty much goes right through Broder.
It'll be 1-1 for A.J. Broder. Came out of the gate on fire, Vince, but he's had some trouble going against some of the bigger, more physical defenders in Ivy League play. He hits the front end. However, he has been, especially defensively, the Quakers' best and most consistent player. Dev Goodman taking a seat there.
That's an interesting substitution by Steve Donahue, putting Darnell Foreman back in this game with the two fouls. So he needs to be smart right here. He's got a tough matchup in Aiken. See if Aiken can recognize, put a little pressure on Foreman.
Tyler Hamilton has checked in. Aiken steps back and hits. Bryce Aiken, another one of those players working for the 14-15 footer.
Yeah, he does a nice job, too, of creating space. That time he gets the elbow out a little bit.
Backdoor cut. Bentley throws it down with one hand. Ryan Bentley to the rack. Penn bench calling for noise as it's a one-point game. Chambers working on Tyler Hamilton. A three launched and hit by Baker. Foreman walking it up as Baker answers in a big way. And a timeout called by Penn with 1:12 left here.
Harvard just with a lot of weapons. Pretty simple dribble penetration right there. Kick out to the big fella Baker. High release, not a whole lot of guys in this building gonna block that one. And he splashes it in from the perimeter. And now we're in that familiar situation. Minute 12 to go, it's the 2-for-1 situation right here. If you're Penn, run 15, 20 seconds off this clock and get a good one. You should get multiple possessions at the end of the half.
At this point, Harvard is locked into the 2 seed in the first ever Ivy League tournament. Penn looking for help. They need to win or else they will be eliminated. They're also looking for Columbia to fall to Yale. But if Columbia should win, there are a series of other tiebreaker scenarios that could see Penn punching their ticket.
There's this 1-3-1 again for Harvard. And they look to switch into man-to-man at the end, but there's Bentley, a pretty open look, catch and shoot three. Quick enough, though, that Harvard has now a chance for a 2-for-1.
Aiken. Harvard whips the ball around. A pull-up. Chambers just short. And Ryan Bentley pulls it down. Penn hurried. It could have been another 2-for-1 situation. Bentley thought about it. Harvard's defense stout there. Goodman passing his way out of trouble, but into the hands of Aiken, all the way to the rack, and it gets blocked from behind by Howard. Oh my, Matt Howard got way up there for the block.
Matt Howard and A.J. Broder both stepping that one off. And Aiken absorbing the blow underneath the basket.
Aiken looks okay. He was out ahead of the pack. And Howard all over that one. Like you said, Broder in the area as well, Vince. Good to see Aiken up and okay.
Big defensive possession right here for Penn. 14 seconds to go. Foreman with those two fouls on Chambers. Chambers should attack him off the bounce, try and pick up that third.
Loses it, got it back. Fade away. Penn comes up with it. Another heave for Howard. Hit one at the end of the first half last night. This one not as close. 4-point lead for Harvard as the first half has expired. Potentially just 20 minutes left in the Quakers' season. Steve Donahue looking to turn things around at the half. We'll be right back with stats, highlights, and analysis when we return on the Ivy League Digital Network.
Back here at the Cathedral of College Basketball, the Palestra. It's 35-31, Harvard by 4 over Penn at halftime. Of course, the final regular season game for each team in the Ivy League. It's time to take a look at scores around the Ancient Eight. And I know there's a lot to unpack, but we'll start with the scores and go from there. Columbia is up by 3 over Yale, 37-34. The other two games have gone final. Cornell beat Brown 92-78, and Princeton destroyed Dartmouth 85-48. To break everything down, all the scenarios, the best in the business, Joe and Vince. Guys?
Bruin, thank you very much. We have new information now. Joe Torti with Vince Curran. All of the convoluted tiebreaker scenarios that we promised you.
Out the window.
Don't matter anymore. Now it's Penn. If they beat Harvard, they punch their ticket to the tournament as the four seed.
No doubt about it, Joe. All the consternation we went through earlier today trying to get it all figured out. Princeton smokes Dartmouth, Cornell beats Brown. So now it comes down to win and you're in. Penn need to take care of business here in the second half, trailing by 4 at halftime.
So as it is at this point, the top three seeds are locked up. It's Princeton, Harvard, Yale in that order. And then it's just the fourth seed up for grabs. Is it going to be Penn? Is it going to be Columbia?
That simple.
So there you go. Take a look here at the tiebreakers, and that's why that happens to be the case. If they both win, if they both lose, based on the information that you have now, the Columbia game is completely inconsequential. The Penn, everything that they have, they don't have to worry about any kind of scoreboard watching. It's all just right in front of them.
They need to watch one scoreboard and one scoreboard only, and that's the one up in the, it's at the west end of the Palestra, the Henry Kell Yang and family scoreboard, which shows Penn down 4 at the half. Long way to go, though, Joe.
So we'll take a look at the stats, highlights, and more analysis when we return. It's halftime here. Penn and Harvard in a close one. We'll be right back with more on the Ivy League Digital Network. Harvard leads by 4 in the Palestra at the half. Penn wins and they're in. Harvard already the 2 seed in the first ever Ivy League tournament. A.J. Broder and the Penn Quakers doing what they can. Let's take a look at the first half highlights here. And Vince, to start things off, it really was the Matt Howard show on senior night for Penn.
First 11 of the game for the Quakers. Did it in a variety of ways off the bounce. Knocked down a couple from the perimeter. There you go. It's like somebody told me what highlights were coming. I was just going from memory right there.
Now Howard muscling his way in, and he really has been unstoppable when he's put the ball on the floor. And you can see there on the defensive end his athleticism rivaling that of Harvard. But Harvard, make no mistake, with some excellent athletes out there on the floor.
Yeah, Zena and Dosamon came in and really gave Tommy Amaker a lift. 8 points and a couple of rebounds. Several energy plays, 4 or 5 grunts. Couple yells, pounding of the chest, but it all kind of creates from Siani Chambers.
And Ryan Bentley stepped up, the freshman on senior night.
And Bentley really, as we said, giving Steve Donahue a lift, and Broder as well.
Even throwing it down, showing some
something,
of his own
something right there. By Ryan Bentley, little lift, little flush. The Quakers, little work cut out for him, down four at the half.
Good news for Penn, the three-point shot has not been a factor for them yet, and they've managed to stay close. Really, you take a look at the field goal percentage as well, has not been a great game shooting, but neither team turning the ball over.
How about the rebounding advantage for Penn? I think that is key, especially with that big athletic Harvard front line. Penn more than handling their own on the glass.
Back to the sidelines in Varun Ragapati.
Half, 13 points in the frame for the senior on senior night, including the first nine for Penn. Talked to Coach Donahue after halftime, and he said that he loved Matt Howard's aggressiveness, the fact that he was up guarding people, and he said that he really gave Penn a lift in that first half, Joe and Vince.
Defend as we begin here. Rune and the entire PSN crew have done a great job all season long here in the final game for them. As Towns back at it right away, he was limited by foul trouble, but he's probably the most explosive scorer for Harvard. Gets started early in the second.
Set play coming right out of the second half. They like Towns' length on Matt Howard. Just rises up over him, gets the ball too deep.
Foreman rises up as well, and Broder there for the tip. Still a four-point game. Towns left open. Don't do that. As Foreman collects the rebound.
Nice job by Donahue, basically guarding two guys on the perimeter.
Broder again. And Lewis outduels him for the board.
Broder catches that one kind of in between steps right there.
Aiken with some fancy dribbling, but no joy. Broder ahead of the pack, and the ball gets stuck. He's fouled.
I think Broder a little frustrated after missing that last one. Really busted end to end. And Darnell Foreman, nice job keeping his head up, seeing the big fella and rewarding him for the effort.
Foreman just floating it ahead. Broder muscling it in. Penn still hasn't missed from the free throw line. They've been the worst free throw shooting team in the Ivy League.
Joe, you can't do that.
Facts are facts.
Yeah, so's the jinx. So's the whamma jamma.
Oh, you're not superstitious, Vince.
Come on, Joe.
Broder had a slow start offensively as he rims that one in. Two-point game.
Don't gloat, Joe. Don't gloat. It's not becoming.
He's got eight now as Chambers trying to spin away. One-on-one, it's Lewis versus Broder. Lewis reposts. That's his shot, Bentley. And now here comes Goodman.
That's too deep for Lewis to get the ball right there. He misses it wildly, but Penn fortunate because that is not terrific post defense, but that is terrific take by Darnell Foreman. Strong to his left hand. Looked like Broder occupying Lewis. The shot blocker allows Foreman to get that one up on the glass. Tie ball game, Joe. Tie ball game.
Squared up at 37. Chambers using the screen. Aiken. Good quick ball fake.
That's a walk.
And here comes Lewis. He can't get it to fall. Combat situation won by Harvard. Towns left open, blocked by Broder. His single season blocks record continues to grow. And looking for the lead, Foreman. Broder, second chance, lays in for two.
As Darnell Foreman's aggressiveness on the offensive end really causing Harvard some problems. He keeps that dribble alive, draws defenders, and that's the second time in the second half that's directly led to a Broder rebound and stick back.
Harvard playing from behind. Aiken, the floater. And Broder asserting himself on the boards.
More good defense by Foreman, challenging Aiken and not fouling.
Howard swoops and scores. Matt Howard with 15 to lead all scorers, and Penn comes flying out of the gates in the second half.
Tommy Amaker has seen enough. You say flying out of the gates. Harvard gets off to a little run, but Penn storming back. And Matt Howard again using that athleticism. The defense key in the offense. A.J. Broder, stick back. Penn holds four.
Penn leading Harvard 41-37 here with 16:51 to go here in regulation time on senior night, along with Vince Curran, Joe Torti here with you. And if you're not here watching the game in person, you can follow the game on Twitter at Penn Basketball, at Harvard B-Ball, at Ivy League Net. Get all kinds of run information, highlights, as Harvard has watched Penn go on a run to begin this second half. Harvard has gone to their bench. And Osamone back in. Gets around Broder. Can't finish. The follow up and in. And Osamone picks up the offensive rebound. Penn with a big rebounding advantage on Harvard early on.
That has been key. A couple of stick backs for Broder. Harvard a lot of one and dones, but not that time. And Osamone there to clean up the loose change.
And then cleans up the layup attempt by Goodman. Floated it up there, and at Osamone just volleyball spiked it out of bounds. Columbia holding four on Yale.
If you're a Penn fan, that game no longer matters, Joe. Penn looking win and you're in.
And if they lose, Columbia would be in the tournament. Bentley gets fouled, and he heads to the free throw line. That's called inside on Robert Baker, the freshman. And that's just his first.
Punch counterpunch with Bentley. He catches it from three. Gets a good look at the catch and shoot. He lets it go. This time he turns the corner, curls the whole way. Could have gotten Ndosumwan there as well, kind of walking his way into Bentley.
Bentley, a rare miss. Rims out there. He's a 92% free throw shooter on the year.
Not anymore, Joe.
It's about 89% in conference play. One for two from the stripe for Bentley. Now Siani Chambers and the Harvard Crimson. Corbin Miller. And Osamone against Broder. Here comes the double, and a near steal by Foreman. Miller sees the three, and he is the three. See the three, be the three, it's 42-42. Harvard draws back to even with Penn.
That's a killer for Penn right there. They get exactly what they want. Strong double team on Ndosumwan, bad pass out. Foreman just fights it and can't secure possession.
Bentley gets hammered, no call, and here comes Harvard. Crimson can take the lead back. Baker wants the tray. And Howard back to the glass. Foreman. Bang! Darnell Foreman feeling it as Penn's back in front by three.
Nice strong rebound by Matt Howard. Gets end to end. And Darnell Foreman, we've talked about it several times. He needs to be a threat out there.
Chambers tried to feed Ndosumwan. He wasn't expecting it. Ball's on the floor.
No reset.
Ndosumwan puts it in and one. He was left all alone after he took the tumble. And he's headed back to the free throw line.
Darnell Foreman not going to want to see the replay of that one. He goes up and challenges Ndosumwan and immediately turns around and looks at Ryan Bentley. Says, that's got to be you, man. Making me look bad, but this is making them look pretty good. Three-pointer spotting Penn to the three-point lead. Harvard back to within one.
Back inside the Palestra, the Penn Quakers cling to a one-point lead. Harvard trying to change that as Zena Ndosumwan at the free throw line trying to square things up at 45. We head to tonight's trivia question.
Oh, yeah.
Vince, you've been on a hot streak here. Who holds the Penn record for most rebounds in a single game.
Wow. All right. I know it's not me.
What?
It's true. Not. What's the number? Tell me what the number is, Joe.
It's in the 30s, Vince.
I would have thought it had been a little higher than that.
And Osem won, a 50% free throw shooter. Rims out, Penn still by one.
I'm going to go Ernie Beck is going to be my guess for that one.
You're on the record.
I'll think about it a little bit more, but I'm inclined to go in that direction.
Jackson Donahue hasn't found much space to operate in this one as Penn trying to punch their ticket to the inaugural Ivy League tournament here at the Palestra, and a moving screen called on A.J. Broder. That's his first.
It's a terrible call. It's just an atrocious call.
Baker all set to inbound as Steve Donahue very upset with that call. Penn still by one.
Rightly so, Joe. Rightly so.
Baker. Chambers. Finds it 0-1 and a foul called underneath. And they'll turn it over. Instead, it'll be a traveling violation. Officials getting together. And then 0-1 shuffled his feet.
I thought the baseline official was going to call the foul. And then Dosamon definitely said, 1, 2, 3.
Baseline official, you can see, motioning for the block.
Yeah, he gets overruled.
Rothschild. Now Howard. Bentley. Donahue competes for the rebound, but Miller comes down with it. And it's nearly picked off by Goodman, swatted out of bounds. And the freshman stops the fast break.
So talk about how Baker's going to be a tough matchup for Bentley on the perimeter. But Bentley does a good job running off some screens right there, gets an open look, and Deb Goodman gets the play. Defensive back. Looks like he had a chance to catch that one, just taps it out of bounds. Harvard maintains possession.
Johnson can't get the shooter's roll that time. Donahue, nice backdoor look, finds Bentley. Howard for three. And Osamone way above everyone to get that board. We've been stuck on 45-44 for quite some time, and there's a foul called as Chambers tried to get by Goodman. That's the third foul called on Goodman.
Siani Chambers puts a little pressure on you. You have Foreman with two, Deb Goodman with three.
Chambers, you know, Vince, you see the point guard facilitating things from the three-point arc, the top of the key. Chambers wants to start the Harvard offense from the free throw line.
Well, he really does a good job of getting deep on his penetration and still looking for his teammates. More so earlier in his career, he'd get into 6-8 feet and still be looking to kick it back out. He's working the perimeter and the elbow a little bit more these days.
And 0-1. He likes this matchup against Rothschild. 10 seconds to shoot as Aiken trying to get around Bentley. Bassey dumped down low at 0-1. The reverse and the putback by Bassey.
And the follow-up for Harvard's number 20, Justin
Bassey. Bassey, Colorado Academy's all-time leading scorer, 2,159 points, gets two there for Harvard. Crimson have the lead back. Penn trying to change that. 12:30 to go in regulation. Now a foul called, and that'll be Towns' third.
Harvard foul number 31, Seth Towns, his third.
Getting a little chippy out there, Joe. A little physical nature of this game picking up.
Three fouls apiece already.
Cancel your dinner reservations, Joe. We're going to be here a while.
Jones, long two. And Johnson rebounds that one. Aiken turns on the Jets. Aiken caught in the air, and Bassey shuffled his feet. Fred Flintstone stepped, and that'll be a traveling violation. Now, Max Rothschild embracing one of the officials down low.
Big hand, and Dosunmu got knotted up, and the official getting in between them. Out of the Penn faithful, wanting multiple traveling violations. There you go, nothing to that one.
All you need is love here
in
Philadelphia.
Give him a kiss, Max, give him a kiss.
Foreman, 8 minutes into this second half as Penn down one to Harvard, fighting for their Ivy League playoff lives. Rothschild has position down low, dumps in, and the wrap pass picked off Johnson.
Dosunmu is in Max Rothschild's head. He's got to catch that in one fluid motion, get that up on the glass.
And Dosunmu jams it in. Wow. Rothschild left all alone. Broder tried to challenge, and it's Harvard by three. Where's the basket going to come from Penn? Rothschild working on Towns. Puts it in himself. Back to within one of the Penn Quakers.
That time Broder flashes and presents himself as a target for Rothschild, but when in doing so brings Ndosunmu away from the basket. Rothschild a little more comfortable with Towns,
who rattles in a three over A.J. Broder. Back and forth these two teams go. Foreman guarded by Aiken. Donahue thought about the three. Inside it's Rothschild again. And a double dribble called on Rothschild.
Well, we talked about it last night. If you dribble it up to control it, I was advocating for that to be a double dribble. As a Penn alum, not crazy about the timing of my wish coming true.
Rothschild gets it done the time before on the offensive end, though. And Penn and Harvard, we've got a good one at the Palestra. Don't go anywhere. Back inside the Palestra, the Penn faithful watching their team fighting for a trip back here to the Palestra next weekend with Vince Curran, Joe Torti, and Vince. Now it's time for the answer to tonight's trivia question.
I'm changing it. Lefko, okay. Bruce Lefkowitz, give it to me.
And the answer? Barton Leach in 1955.
I wasn't getting that. I could have changed it 17 times and I wasn't getting that.
Foul called underneath as Aiken attacked the basket. And the freshman heads to the stripe.
Ben Bell was on number 24, Matt
called
Howard
on Matt Howard, and the seniors had a nice night for Penn. Looked like he was the last guy
Aiken
there.
At the line, shooting two.
And perhaps the last one who should have been called for the foul, but as it is, it's just his first. Foreman and Goodman each playing for Penn with three fouls as Aiken hits. Aiken, the top free throw shooter on this Crimson team, coming into this one, just missed 10 free throws all year. Harvard back up six. Foreman with a step. Broder absorbs the contact, can't get it to fall, but he heads to the stripe. A.J. Broder has really taken steps to work on his free throw shooting. Once that becomes a consistent go-to for him, you'll see his scoring total skyrocket because he gets a lot of attempts.
Nice catch in traffic. Good dribble penetration by Foreman, turning the corner, drawing a couple defenders.
He rims out there. Just the second missed free throw for Penn tonight. Ryan Bentley missed one earlier. That's a rare sight. One for two for Broder. 5-point lead for Harvard. Johnson, dagger three. And Howard skies above Baker for the rebound. Goodman Bang, the freshman right in front of the Penn bench.
It's a big one for Dev Goodman. Matt Howard with the rebound, end to end. Darnell Foreman head up, finds Dev Goodman on the handoff.
Lewis all alone inside, quiets the crowd.
That time Matt Howard late coming over to help A.J. Broder, who got walked up the lane a little bit. Actually walked out of the lane by Lewis.
Bentley was looking down low. Here's Howard, who had an explosive first half. He leads Penn with 15 points. Goodman gets caught in the air. Bentley with two to shoot. And that's a shot clock violation. Good defense again by Harvard.
The defense need a little better recognition by Penn.
Goodman, who hit the three a moment ago, nearly had a chance to throw that one up at the end, got the ball late.
A little blood on Aiken, it looks like, heading over to the Harvard bench.
It's been a rough and tumble night for Bryce Aiken. Chris Baker will check in. Towns all set to inbound after Aiken receives repairs on the sideline. Lewis working on Broder. Lewis once again reposting. The reverse. What a move by Chris Lewis for two.
Lewis big and strong as a man can't come, to quote Jim Croce. Does baseline right there, does a nice job of the post, repost.
Goodman with a good look.
Impressed by Bentley's motion. He's been putting pressure on that Harvard defense with a series of cuts and moving off screens. That time, not quite able to get there, but solid offensive basketball by Ryan Bentley.
Lewis taking a seat and throws someone back in. Eight and a half minutes left. Broder trying to get Penn closer. He gets fouled on the hook shot by Adosimwon. That's his third.
Harvey foul was on number four. Is that Adosimwon, his third, team's fifth.
The official calls him Adosimwon for kind of walking up underneath Broder. That's a feeling he's got to be used to. A lot of teams trying to take away his power and strength by working that lower body.
Rims out again. And it's been tough sledding at the line for Broder this season, coming in below 60%. One for two again on this trip. He's got a dozen. Max Rothschild will check in and give Broder a breather. Rothschild, one of those spark plug players for Penn. They could use some energy right now, trailing Harvard by five.
Rothschild's got to look to be aggressive offensively. He's gotten the ball several times in this game in position to score. I think the Harvard shot blockers are in his head a little bit.
As he runs behind it, 0-1. Howard comes away with the rip. Foreman wants three. And that'll go down to Harvard. Under 8 minutes remaining here at the Palestra. Will it be the final 7 minutes and 59 seconds of Matt Howard's career? He and the Penn Quakers trying to make sure that that's not the case. But Zena Adosimwon and the Harvard Crimson going to work. Lewis on the wraparound reverse.
Coming down the stretch here at the Palestra, Harvard 57, Penn 52, a five-point game and a close one that features three prominent members of Steve Donahue's first recruiting class, Ryan Bentley, A.J. Broder, and of course the freshman point guard Dev Goodman. They've combined for 23 of the 52 Penn points. And talking with Coach Donahue, he said a couple weeks ago in non-conference they weren't ready. Our rotation wasn't flushed out. They're ready now and they're playing big minutes.
Varun, thank you very much. Penn down five as Harvard looking to build on their lead. Inside 8 minutes left. And Osem one. Chambers lobs it up. And Osem one. And a foul called underneath. This is on Howard. It's his second. No, it'll be on Rothschild. It's number two for Rothschild as well.
Tough call from Max Rothschild, and Dosemwan plays so physically down there, post, repost, active. At the end of it, you can see Rothschild just trying to keep his hands up, but he gets that right hand out, which I think is what the official was calling.
And Dosemwan hits the first one from the free throw line, a 50% free throw shooter on the nose coming into this one. Rothschild takes a seat.
And for Harvard, number 35, Robert Baker is back in, replacing Seth Towns.
Each of these teams, Vince, go into their bench early and often. Free substitutions from both Steve Donahue and Tommy Emmett. One for two from the line, and it's Howard again with the rebound. Penn looking to cut into this Crimson lead. Broder, how about a three? Bang for A.J. Broder. He can shoot from out there.
For as good as Ndosumwan is defensively, that's not an area where he wants to go. It's a shot at the top of the key. Broder may see a couple more times before this one's all said and done.
It's now 8 for 19 on the year from three-point land. And it's a three-point game just like that. Poked away from Chambers. Here comes Goodman. All the way to the rack. Goodman lays it in for two. Penn bench thrilled to be back down one.
Dev Goodman, long arms, quick hands, and explosiveness actually runs away from Siani Chambers, which you don't often see. And the Quakers cutting it to one. Wanting to play a little more hoops, Joe.
Aiken. Working on Foreman. Chambers, who just had his pocket picked, steps back over Goodman. And that's out of bounds. Quaker ball. This Quaker crowd not ready to see basketball stop here at the Palestra. They want to see Penn punch their ticket to next weekend's Ivy Madness Ivy League tournament. If Penn wins, they're in. Howard gets it blocked and a hard foul as well. Howard looks okay. He pops right up.
And Howard looked like he was trying to turn that one over as he starts. And then at the last second, he goes finger roll.
That's number four on Zena at Osamor. See him cupping it as he brings it up.
Yeah, they could have gotten Baker or Ndosumwan on that one.
Howard. Now 4 for 5 from the free throw line. Ndosumwan takes a seat as Lewis back in. Seth Towns gives Baker a break. And Johnson checks in for Justin Bassey. Tie game. All square, Penn and Harvard at the Palestra. Senior night for Matt Howard, and he gives Penn the tie game.
Good job by Broder, squaring Lewis up right there.
Nearly thrown away, and it's Howard. Foreman, how about the three? Timeout Harvard.
And back come the Quakers. Matt Howard with the steal end to end. After the steal, he gets it back from Darnell Foreman and knocks down the big three on senior night. Matt Howard, double-double already, wanting to play on.
Matt Howard, playing in his 100th career game as a Quaker, wants to see number 101. Got a good look and said, give me all three of those. Scenarios are simple, like we said, win and you're in. Penn has reclaimed the lead against
Harvard. It is now down to scenario, Joe.
All
the iterations are out the window. The scenarios are out the window. The scenarios whereby heretofore, what needs to happen is Penn needs to win tonight, and that's it. Period, paragraph, win, and you're in the inaugural Ivy League tournament.
So is Harvard. They're locked into the number two spot. These two teams, if they were to meet in the tournament, it would be in a final situation. Look at Matt Howard, the production that he's had on senior night. He's been all over the place for Penn. Another double-double. Chambers, a senior, nearly ran into a double.
Travel. Good
and
call.
A traveling violation.
Chambers puts so much pressure on the Penn defense. He's attacking. Towns is trailing in behind. They're thinking three right there out of the break. Towns just gets it in between steps. Shot.
Bentley showed the ball all the way in. Rolls it in for two, Ryan Bentley. He's into double digits as well. One of three Penn players on the floor, led by Howard's 19. Aiken has 10 for Harvard.
11-0 run for Penn, Joe?
That's what it is. Chambers trying to end it, and he does with a big triple.
He does and sells a few wolf tickets to Dev Goodman on the way by. Said, that's what I got for you, freshman.
Penn still leads by two.
Ten seconds on the shot. And a man from Harvard.
Foreman floats it to Goodman. He has to put it up. How did that go in?
We'll talk about Dev Goodman. A couple possessions ago, not realizing the shot clock was winding down. I think he's actually listening to the Penn band that time, who helps him out. He gets one up on the glass. Never up, never in, Joe.
Aiken back to work. Lewis, good athlete on the low post. Towns has been limited for Harvard. Chambers all the way in. Spins that one in and one right as the shot clock expired. Clutch shot by the senior.
I'm ready to see him go, Joe.
I think a lot of Penn faithful would say the same thing.
Ready to see him go. Holy cow, end of the shot clock. He sees it winding down, no panic in him, attacks with his strong left hand, gets it up on the glass, and had a chance to cut this to a one-point lead. Creates the body contact with Dev Goodman. Senior leadership, can't beat it.
Penn faithful, something to cheer about as Penn leads Harvard by two. They used an 11-0 run to climb back in against the Crimson, and now the two teams trading buckets alongside Vince Curran, Joe Torti, courtside at the Palestra. And it's a lot of nervous looks here. As you see, there's not much between these two teams at all. Almost identical stats across the board as senior Siani Chambers steps to the free throw line. Chambers one for one in this game, rims out on the and one. Penn leads by two. If they win, they're in the inaugural Ivy League tournament. They'll return here next Saturday, or Friday rather, next weekend to play Princeton. Here's Foreman, lost it on the way up.
A good entry pass right there by Darnell Foreman.
Perfect touch. Broder muscles it up, no call. Ball still up, tapped around, and it bounces to Harvard. Chambers, Baker all the way to the hoop. That won't go. Foreman downshifts. Approaching that 3 minute mark, Penn leads by a bucket. Howard, he's got 21, looking for 22 at the free throw line.
Steve Donahue, nice job calling Darnell Foreman back out. That was a set play for Matt Howard. He wanted to get him coming off the dribble. You saw Dev Goodman and Darnell Foreman clear through. And then Matt Howard coming in behind. Now the Quakers, who were so good from the free throw line in the first half, only 6 for 10 here in the second half. The big one for Matt Howard.
And he hits. Matt Howard saving one of his best performances for potentially the last one. That's a season high 22 for Matt Howard. Aiken all the way in, puts it up acrobatically. He wears number 11 because Kyrie Irving wore number 11. He attended the same high school, finished like Kyrie right there. One more point will tie Matt Howard's career high with 23. And you'd expect Penn to go to him down the stretch. And a timeout called on the floor. Penn will take it.
With 13 seconds on the shot clock, Steve Donahue directing traffic to bring the ball over right in front of the Penn bench. Same spot from last night where they ran the play to get A.J. Broder on the block but couldn't get the entry pass from Jackson Donahue. I tell you, I like Bentley as your inbounder and stepping right back. Quick hitter just like that. So many times teams forget about the inbounder.
You know, especially if you do a play that, you know, almost all plays are designed to end up in the corner, right? So you inbound to the corner and then pass back up to the wing.
I think you're also looking at action away to get a screen for A.J. Broder, flash to the hard side box, looking to inbound top of the key, Darnell Foreman area, and back to Bentley for a three. Let's see who the inbounder is.
It looked for a moment like it would be Bentley. It's Goodman. A.J. Broder contributing in the second half as well.
It's like Harvard in a zone for the first time in a while. The first half, they would switch out of this late into a man-to-man.
Foreman trying to shoot him out of it. It'll still be Penn by three. Aiken accelerating. Just now slowing down. Aiken give and go and gets it blocked by Howard. Oh, baby. It'll stay here with Harvard off of Foreman's head when he was on the ground. Boy, oh boy, Matt Howard.
Darnell Foreman takes one in the grill right there. Aiken kind of jumps into him. I think the Penn bench is calling for the non-basketball move, but there's a basketball move right there. Matt Howard sending it back in the other direction. The senior filling up the stat sheet right now.
Aiken is going to see Howard in his nightmares as Foreman picks that one off. And now Penn slows it down. Inside 2 minutes left, Penn by three. If Penn's able to hold on, they earn the right to play another day. Howard, all the way in, muscles it in, a new career high. That's 24 points for Matt Howard.
Harvard's got to send Matt Howard in the other direction. He keeps going to that strong right hand. He's just killing him right now.
Towns answers on the other end, and a timeout called by Tommy Amaker. With 88 seconds remaining here at the Palestra. Vince, we've got a nice boring game to end Penn's regular season.
A quick answer by Harvard right there. Towns off the bounce using that long athletic frame. Obviously a very nice player. And it is punch counter punch down the stretch, Joe.
Howard so strong. We saw Chambers finish at the other end. Seniors putting on a show in the air.
And Darnell Foreman on the other end, let's not discount that. He kind of deeps Chambers into throwing that, what looks like an open pass to the baseline. He's almost like a quarterback in football trying to get the quarterback to throw it into the wrong window. So a rare turnover by Siani Chambers late.
You talk about turnovers, Vince, there haven't been many of them in this game. That might be the 10th for Harvard. And they're the only team in double digits. Both teams taking very good care of the basketball with stakes raised here.
Stakes couldn't be any higher for Penn right now. Win, you get to play on. Lose, your season is likely over.
Penn with 5 blocks and 5 steals. Matt Howard with a couple monster ones on Bryce Aiken. Take a look at the scoring leaders. 15 points for Zena Edosamwon. He's got 4 fouls for Harvard. Matt Howard, a career-high 24 points, and he's also tied his career-high in rebounds, saving his finest game for senior night.
It looks like he got the memo. This is it. No more practice. Matt Harvard in the zone again. Last time it was a short possession, only 13 seconds on the shot clock. This time the full 30. Let's see what they do if they switch out of it late.
And it does look like that's what they've done. Yep. Gone to man-to-man.
Great
shot.
Oh
my gosh, Goodman to the rim. Left his man in the dust, and it's Penn by 5 with a minute to play.
Overplay, Goodman, hard back door. Penn, as Harvard's in that man-to-man, drags everybody out. There's nobody there to protect the rim.
Aiken gets hit and one from the free throw line. Fouled the jump shooter. And that's on Darnell Foreman. Foreman picks up his 4th. And a huge play here if Aiken can convert at the line.
Bryce Aiken at the line, one shot.
Aiken good at hitting those off-balance shots, and Foreman got him late. Aiken 3-for-4 from the stripe. Hits. Corey Johnson checking in, as well as Robert Baker. Penn leads by 2, just under 53 seconds left at the Palestra.
Penn should run this all the way down. They score here late in the shot clock. Make it very difficult for Harvard.
15 left on the shot clock as Penn trying to get the offense moving.
Same play for Matt Howard. They were looking for him turning the corner. Good recognition.
Howard left open for 3. Bentley trying to keep it alive, but it's Harvard ball. 2-point game, 24 seconds left. Aiken all the way to the rim.
Gonna call a foul.
And a foul called inside. And that'll go against Foreman. That's number 5. Darnell Foreman has fouled out. So Penn will have to go to the bench here. Foreman with a handful of Aiken's left arm.
So we're going to get 1-1 here for Aiken. The worst case if you're Penn should be overtime.
Well, don't talk to that to Harvard about that. They've had 2 scenarios against Princeton where a missed free throw has resulted in a de facto 4-point possession. So Penn's got to do their part and block out on a missed free throw.
So it's going to be Jackson Donahue in for Darnell Foreman.
Donahue started this game, as did Foreman. Goodman started the game on the bench. Foreman fouls out with 7 points. The junior with a fine defensive effort, especially for Penn. Aiken, an 88% free throw shooter. Had a very quiet game against Princeton. Has rebounded in a big way. He's got 16 points. Was held to just 1 bucket late against the Tigers. Looked shaken, looked rattled. And now he is back at the free throw line, looking more confident. As he goes 2-for-2, it's a tie game. Penn will have the chance for the last shot. And now Siani Chambers checks back in for Johnson. Dev Goodman really the lone ball handler on the floor for Penn as Harvard extends their defense. Penn calls timeout with just under 17 seconds left.
Weren't we just here last night, Joe? 12 seconds left last night. Penn calls timeout to set an sideline out of bounds. 16 seconds left tonight. Now Penn not trailing tonight.
It was a heartbreaking loss last night to Dartmouth. In fact, if they'd beaten Dartmouth, all of this is actually academic at this point.
Yeah, you could say the same thing if they'd beaten Columbia last week, too. It would all be academic.
But they do have the chance now, and this is what they asked for. You saw the quote from Steve Donahue. They have their own destiny in their hands.
I'm running the play for Matt Howard. Harvard hasn't adjusted to it yet. He's turned the corner. He's getting to the basket. I have Broder setting the screen for him and trailing the play behind. That's the one I'm looking for.
He's Vince Curran, I'm Joe Torti. Glad you could join us here for an instant classic on the Ivy League Digital Network. Harvard and Penn. Penn playing for the right to enter the first ever Ivy League tournament. That fourth seed is theirs if they're able to win. And there's only 17 seconds left here. Yale does end up beating Columbia 75-71.
So Yale beats Columbia. Cornell beats Brown. Princeton smacks Dartmouth.
We'll see what Penn can do here on what should be the final possession.
The last 16 seconds of the Ivy League regular season potentially here, Joe. You get Deb Goodman, the freshman, gonna have a full head of steam. They don't want to start this before 8.
Shot clock obviously turned off. Goodman, Donahue, a 3. Oh, he got it from Jackson Donahue. Are you kidding me? 6
press
seconds
up.
Left.
Now you got to press up. Steve Donahue saying foul him, saying foul him.
Chambers could have traveled. Corner kick. Johnson wants a 3 as well. It's no good. The tip-in doesn't count. And Penn punches their ticket to the Ivy League tournament. Penn beats Harvard 75-72 at the Palestra.
Wow, after an 0-6 start in the league, Penn fights all the way back. Jackson Donahue, who has struggled from the perimeter this year, a gigantic 3 to send Penn into the Ivy League tournament.
Delivering in a big way on senior night, and they'll have at least one more game. The Quakers are coming back to the Palestra. There was no plan B on this play, Vince. All Jackson Donahue all the time, and the sophomore delivers.
Baker with a pretty good challenge. Steve Donahue is trying to get Dev Goodman to take a foul on Chambers. Harvard gets a really good look at it at the end. Wow, Joe.
Steve Donahue with a big relieved smile talking to assistant coach Ira Bowman. The streamers fly in the Palestra. And we'll see you next weekend. Palestra roars its approval as Penn punches their ticket to the Ivy League tournament. They'll face top-seeded Princeton here in what is a home game, no doubt about it, for the Penn Quakers.
A play on for the Quakers. That's all you were looking for at 0-6. It didn't look too great, but somehow the adjustments were made. I think Ryan Bentley giving Penn a reliable perimeter scorer certainly helped with that. But the biggest shot of the year for Penn from Jackson Donahue to now, send Penn into the postseason.
Now we'll head down to the sidelines, and Varun Ragapathy standing by with Steve Donahue and the player of the game, Matt Howard.
All righty, with Coach Donahue and the hero, Matt Howard. Coach, what does it say about this team to lose to Dartmouth at home, come back, and beat an even better Harvard team on this floor?
It's a lot more than that. Start our season out 0-6. With 4 more straight on the road coming. What these guys done is amazing to me. Just never giving up. Matt was incredible tonight, but he's been incredible for his 4 years in terms of wanting us to do well. He deserved it tonight.
Matt, you certainly picked a great day for a career high, 24 points, double-double as well. Where does this game rank among all that you've played here at the Palestra?
Oh, it's definitely my favorite. It's my first opportunity to be in the postseason, so it's a great feeling.
And you guys are playing on the Palestra floor in the first ever Ivy League tournament. What does that mean to you?
It's a great feeling to know we're going to be on our home court. It gives us a great advantage, and we're going to do our best to get a win on when we play Princeton next week, later on this week.
Last question for you, Matt. You're the senior leader of this team. You helped carry them, but you had three freshmen and then Jackson Donahue come up big in this one as well. What does it say about their performance in a big game like this?
I mean, we're just we always play with a complete team effort. We never we believe in each and every one of our players, and we don't care who scores. So anybody can step up at any time, and that's what makes us a good team. That's why we came back from the 0-6 start.
Well, you're playing more basketball at the Palestra. We'll see you next week, Matt.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Guys?
Thank you very much. Congratulations to Steve Donahue and Matt Howard as the Penn Quakers put a bow on a thriller, instant classic, downing Harvard. And now Harvard's lost two in a row heading into the tournament. Penn headed to the tournament.
Back and forth this game went. It looked like Harvard had a little momentum. Penn with a big 11-0 run to get themselves back in it. And Jackson Donahue on senior night for Matt Howard. Well, it's sophomore night. He gets a moment of his own. A gigantic three. And Penn heading into the Ivy League tournament next week.
For Vince Curran, Varun Ragapathy, and everybody at the Penn Sports Network who made this broadcast possible, Joe Torti. See you next time.